travel. This is just time warm-ups now.
Gentlemen, at this time, proceed to your first command. competitive event.
We have Rustin coming up next round. Number 339. Rusty.
Watch, Dave.
4-5. Oh, no problem. Four point five over. And Davis score on the pound. And this is John. That was Davis score. 4.5 over. Davis score. John's score was a 4.60, as you can see. John's score. Kevin. He's on his knees. I think he's praying for his team. Next we have Aaron McIntosh. We have 340, my son David Ruiz. David just wrapped one of the reins around the block. I think we're playing a kicking contest here. got a six. There you go, John. John? Let it go, John. Let it go, Rusty.
Nice. spot, Ryan.
What's up, man?
going to go back up and finish his high bar routine, but the judges made him stop. They didn't want him to continue. And possibly an injury. And he looks okay. Kevin.
Yeah. As long as you get it out of control.
I was there. Let's go, Dave. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, your pommel horse champion. Receiving the sixth place award, also with a score of 7.175, but a higher all-around, from Wyatt's, John Paul Carroll. We have a tie for fourth place, receiving the fifth place award with a score of 7.2. Ladies and gentlemen, your vault champion.
Youngest.
He combines power and quickness so well. He's so quick with his arms up. He finishes with a double layout.
You know, since the 1996 Olympics, the judges eliminated compulsories. You know, the routines where the gymnasts all do them identically, and they're judged on their technique and their precision. Well, these are optional exercises we're seeing here, but because so many gymnasts are using the same combinations to get bonus points, it seems like the optionals are starting to look like compulsories.
Well, Lee's score 9.537, good enough for third place right now. We continue on the floor with Sergei Fedorchenko of Kazakhstan. He's 22 years old, 5'8", a bit taller than the rest of the gymnasts.
Fedorchenko is known as a trickster. He's one of those guys that does every trick in the book. Look at that opening tumbling run. And every piece of equipment is the same. We're going to have a chance to see him in the finals on high bar later, and you're not going to believe what he dares to do there.
He twists so fast.
One of those gymnasts that's admired by nearly all the other gymnasts because he really dares to go for really hard stuff. In some ways, he's not as stylish as you might see Alexei Nemov, but in terms of difficulty, few people match him. Ironic to give away a couple of tenths of a point on a silly bobble like a scale. He's resting up for his last tumbling run. Oh, no!
It's a long body to get around two times in layout position.
And that's too bad, because he might have had a shot at a medal if he could have pulled around that last tumbling run.
Oh, you can see he's rubbing his ankles.
Yeah, that hurts.
Here is why. Look in slow motion the position of his ankle on the landing. I guarantee you every single gymnast in this arena just cringed right here, knowing what that feels like.
Munch.
And this doesn't feel too good either. 8.625. So let's take a look at the final results from the men's floor exercise. Sexy Alexei. Alexei Nemov of Russia takes home the gold. Dmitry Karbienko of France, the silver. Li Xiaoping, the bronze. The women will take center stage when we return. We'll see the world's all-around champion, Svetlana Horkina, perform on the uneven bars.
I guess I've been bringing the office home with me. Because lately I've had some pain at night, and I just couldn't get to sleep. And then I'd worry about taking something. I mean, I'm at work pretty early, you know. How would I feel? But then I tried Tylenol PM. That's something I can trust. Well, the Tylenol PM stopped my pain. It helped me sleep. Next morning, I'm up and out and ready for my day. Nothing like a good night.